Do you want to give someone limited access to the data that lives inside of your no-code database? When I say limited access, I mean maybe you want them to be able to interact with the team, maybe do a little bit of chatting, but not necessarily pay for them as a user. Well, SmartSuite has solved this problem for us by including a special tier of user called guest. In this video, I'm gonna be breaking down the value of the guest user role and exactly why you'll want to implement the guest user inside of some of your SmartSuite projects. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. SmartSuite is one of our favorite no-code tools, and in this video, I'm gonna be sharing with you the power of the guest user role. This is a user role that is very unique to SmartSuite. I haven't seen this type of permission level really in any other similar software. And the best part about the guest user role is that it's going to keep your costs down. If there is somebody on your team who only needs a little bit of access, they don't need full access to your solution, guest user permissions might be the right thing for you. And it's not going to cost you to have that additional user accessing your information. That being said, it's still pretty collaborative. You're gonna see in this video that the guest user can still communicate inside of a particular solution, but they will have very limited access. But before we go any further down the guest user role rabbit hole, I wanna first invite you to join me for some automation training. Automation is the cornerstone of anything you're gonna do inside of no-code software, and it's gonna save you a ton of time and not to mention improve your accuracy and efficiency. So if you wanna learn the fundamental building blocks of automation, whether that's in SmartSuite or Zapier or make.com, whatever tools you're using, first grab my automation training completely free at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. Wherever you found this video, I will include links so that you can get signed up for that training. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. And to start, we're gonna talk about pricing because this is really what's gonna add a lot of value to the guest user role. So here I am on SmartSuite's pricing page. This is their current pricing model. You'll see that you've got the ability to add only 3 users on a free plan. That goes up to unlimited users when you get to paid plans, but you're gonna be charged, as is true for most no-code tools, per user that has access to whatever it is you're building. So if you're on the enterprise plan here, you're going at $41 a month US or $35 if you're paying annually per user. And the per user part is really important because as you grow your organization, SmartSuite is going to scale with you, but so will your bill. Your bill is also going to increase as you add more and more people to your team. Now that being said, the guest user role is perfect for anybody who is outside of the day-to-day operations, or maybe they're ancillary in the sense that they're not a permanent part of your team. Maybe you've just added some temps, or you need to grant limited access perhaps to some stakeholders. Well, you can do this without opening everything up to them and only giving them that very limited vision of what they need. Now, you don't see it here on the pricing page, but when we get into adding those guest user types, we will see that they will not be added into our bill. And this is one of the most underrated features inside of SmartSuite because so many different CRM tools that you might use are going to not give you access to invite someone, but only give them limited access like this and give that to them for free. And that's what we're going to be breaking down. So let's go ahead and flip now into my screen, and I'm gonna share with you a quick little setup that I've got for tracking some projects. It's a pretty easy solution. We've got 3 different applications. I have my contacts here, and no information really for these contacts other than their names. I've got Alpha, Bravo, and Charlie. And if we go into our projects, we're gonna see that we're working on 3 different projects that link over to that contacts application. Okay, so then we've assigned these projects to somebody. Now, for the sake of this demo, I've assigned something to Eric here, I've assigned something to myself, and I haven't yet assigned something to a third user. Now, this is where I want to actually bring in that guest role. Maybe I've got someone who just got added, and again, maybe they're in a temporary position, and I don't yet need them to have full-blown access to SmartSuite. Well, one thing that I could do is share access to this application, specifically just read-only access here. Now, while I can do that in a lot of tools, but I could create my share view here, and I could say, look, anybody who has access to this link can just see this. But if we were to preview this link, what we would see is that we have access to this URL, and it's gonna share with us everything that is in this application, in this view. So of course we could hide certain things, but we would have to do that manually at the view level. We would have to apply filters, apply sorts, groups, all of that, in order to impact the way that people see that data. And again, it wouldn't be filtered down specific to the user. It is just however the settings of the view are. Now we can do this in a lot of tools, but what we want to do here is take this to the next level. Actually invite someone to collaborate with us where they can only see their stuff and even communicate with us in the application itself. This is all possible with the guest user role. So let's add a new user. The easiest way to do this is to just come down and add a new person here. This is going to assume that we have admin privileges and that we are allowed to add more people to our account. So all I need to do here is add the email address of the person I want to add here as a guest user, and I can select their role before I send the invitation. Now here, if we scroll on down to the bottom role, we see that the guest user permissions can only be added to solutions as a read-only viewer, but is free. So this person, this user role, will never incur charges against our user count for our particular workspace. So I'll make that selection here. And here we can also add what kind of member type they are if we have the different types selected. And we can also assign them to teams. So in previous videos, we've showcased how the teams can allow you to onboard people more quickly, giving them access to specific solutions and applications. If you want to add them to a team, you get the ability to do so here. And once you're happy with these settings, you can go ahead and send that invitation. Now I'm going to go ahead and pick that invitation up in my email. But before we get to that, I also want to go to our third application here, which is tasks. And here we're able to look up the person in charge of the project. So here Eric was in charge of project one, but we might assign the task to someone else. So maybe here, these tasks are going to be assigned to me, let's say. And similarly, I might assign myself one of these tasks, but perhaps these two tasks are going to be assigned to our new guest role. So we have the ability to assign people within the project and then also at the task level. So again, just a quick recap, this particular field is showing us the person who is assigned to the project, and this field here is showing us the person who is assigned to the task. Now we're gonna flip into my personal email address where I have just been invited to join SmartSuite as a guest user. I'm gonna accept the invitation here and go ahead and open up SmartSuite again now with the new user permissions. I am now going to be logged in as a guest user once I get through the onboarding. So I will first establish my name. I will call this account Gareth Guest. Now I select my title and my department as needed, and I can continue to the next part where I set up my authentication method. I'll go ahead and assign a password so that I can then join the Gap Consulting workspace that I have been invited to participate in. Again, this is showing you exactly what your guest users are going to experience when they are setting up their accounts. And then once this is all done, I will have access to whatever has been shared with me. Now, while we are waiting for our new guest to be accepted into the new workspace, I'm first going to go back from my admin account. And now that they've accepted the invitation, I can find them from the list here. Here is Gareth Guest, and I can assign them to things. So here in this example, I'm going to assign them to these tasks, but I'm also going to flip into projects and assign the new guest user to the project as well. So I can come in here and again, find our guest and bring him in right here. So only by adding our guest to these records are we going to then make the records available to our guest for viewing in the first place. I also want to highlight that I can open up the conversation element here and I can have a discussion with this guest. I can actually at reference them and bring them up here now because they are an active member, even though they have a free account, and I can collaborate with them right here and say, please review this and send this message to that new user. Now that we've got this all rocking, let's go ahead and flip into the experience that our guest is going to see when they log into the tool. Here we are back on our guest login page. They've just finished going through the assignment of getting signed up here, and we can say, got it. And we have to find first the particular solution that we're using in this case. It is the project tracking solution. You can see that by default, they're going to have access to all of the solutions that were shared across our workspace. But due to the permission type of this user, they are only able to see those things that they have been assigned to. So here we are inside of the guest vision of this application. And here we are on the tasks application, and only those things where the guest user has been assigned are they able to see. So if we recall, there were actually 9 different tasks across 3 different projects, but this guest user only sees the 2 different tasks that they've been assigned to. Now they also do see the information that was sent to them here on this particular field. So as I reached out as an admin, I chatted with this person, they can use the conversation element here and reply just as easily as any user inside of our SmartSuite account. The one thing they cannot do is edit this information here. So they can't come in and change the description. You see that that's locked. They cannot unassign themselves to something, but they can access the status of this thing because this is assigned to them. So they do have access to actually edit the status, and they can say, hey, this is actually ready for review, or hey, this is now complete. Let's move on. So they can collaborate inside of the record. They can access anything that pertains to a status for a task that they have been assigned to, but that is the extent of the editing capabilities that this user has. Now, in addition to this, they can also see all of this information inside of My Work. So just as any other user inside of SmartSuite, they can go to the My Work checkbox and see all of the different tasks that have been assigned to them across all of the different applications and solutions that they may be members of. Now, in addition to this, I might want to get some more information about the people that I'm working with on this team. This is especially helpful if I am a little fringe to the organization. I'm a new contractor, for example. Well, in this case, I might need to know, who is this person who just messaged me? Well, I can always at reference this person and actually open up right here and go to their full profile. So just by hovering over here, I can fall in right here and access that view profile. So once I access this, I can see all the information about this individual, who they are within the organization, maybe their email or phone number to get a hold of them. And if they've included their social networks, I can also go ahead and stalk them on Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, and or Facebook. So a lot of opportunity here in terms of enhancing my collaboration. And of course, this is entirely free for me to join as a user. I just have that limited functionality. Now, to take this just one layer deeper, I of course also have a project assigned to me. So as you see, I flip into projects and I can see that project assigned to me. But I do want to highlight for you that in the case where I have been assigned the project, I don't see the tasks associated with that project here. Maybe over here in projects, if I expand this particular project, I'm able to scroll down and see the tasks. And of course, I can click on them, but nothing is going to happen because I don't have permission to view the task itself. Now, again, if I flip back into my admin user permissions, it's going to show all the data in this database. Well, we see that this guest account does have this project assigned, but because the task is not assigned to this individual, they are not able to see these tasks. So do note that it matters where someone is assigned to a record. Even if it links to other stuff, they're not able to see the other stuff. This could be good, it could be bad, depending on the type of access you were intending to grant. So make sure that you're assigning people at the record level. If they are guest users, to make sure that they can see what you need them to see. Hey, I know we went pretty fast in this video. There was a lot to cover about guest user permissions. So if you have any other questions that we didn't quite get to, be sure to drop them below the video. And in the meantime, keep on building.